Hello and welcome to Quick Tips. In this video, I'll show you three free plugins to create a form in WordPress website. All the three plugins are good and free to use. The first one is Contact Form 7. The next one is Caldera Contact Form. And the third one is WP Form. This video is just an introduction to all these Contact Form plugins for the WordPress website. In the coming videos, I'll show you how to create forms using these three plugins. So let's start with the first plugin, that is Contact Form 7.
Those who are watching my videos for the first time, check out the playlist on my YouTube channel. You will find free YouTube video courses. Subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that you will get instant notification whenever I publish new free YouTube video course or new video tutorial.
Now we are on the website where we are going to install the Contact Form 7. So let's go to plugin, then go to add new. Now search for Contact Form 7. Alright, so you will see this Contact Form 7. This is the first search result. Click on it and install. Click on activate. Now here in the left panel you will see this option contact. Click on it and it will show you contact forms. Now you will see a dummy form, the first. By default, one form is created there. You can click on edit. Now this is how the contact form will look like. So you will see these are the fields that you can use to create the forms. This is the text, the simple text, email, the URL, the telephone number, number, date, text area, drop down menu, checkboxes, ready buttons, acceptance, quiz, file and submit. Now these are the fields that you can use to create a simple contact form using this plugin. Now in the next video, in the coming videos, I'll show you how to use all these fields and create form using this plugin. Now here you will see the mail. These are the mail settings. Here you can enter the email address where you want to receive the emails. This is from email address. This is the subject of this form. And here you will see the message body. Okay, let's see how does this look on the actual page. Now this is the short code. Let's go to one of the pages. Here I have one test page. Okay, now copy this short code. Now we are on the edit page. Now here you will see I'm not using any plugin, a page builder plugin, so I'm just clicking on plus and look for a short code. You will see this one. Select this one and enter the short code here and update it. Now see how does this look on the page. Okay, so this is how the contact form will look. Okay, so this is a very simple basic contact form. As I said, I'll show you how to create different, how to use different fields of this contact form and create beautiful contact forms. Now the next one is Caldera form. Okay, so let's go to install plugins. Let's go to add new. Okay, now search for Caldera, Caldera form. Okay, not this one, you see this one, Caldera forms more than contact forms. Click on install now. Done. Now activate. Okay, now in the left panel you will see Caldera forms. Go to Caldera forms. Now here are the settings. This is the dashboard. Now here you will see new form. Now these are the templates, the pre-built template. You can use one of these templates or you can create blank form and add the fields manually. So let's try this one. The first let's try this one. Enter the name for the form and create form. Okay, so this is the template they have given. First name, last name, mobile number, email address. So these are the fields in this template. If you want to add more field, you can simply click on plus. If you want to add here, you can click on plus. Now these are the fields, single line, hidden, email button, phone number, number. These are the fields, the select option, drop down, checkbox, radio, There are many different fields that you can use. HTML is also there, e-commerce is also there, specials are also there. Okay, so in the coming videos, I'll show you how to use Caldera Form to build a contact form, and we will try to cover all the fields in a simple, in a single contact form. That will be in the next video. Okay, so let's save this form, or you can, let's check the settings of this form. Here you will see email. This is the form name. You can change it to whatever you want. You can simply change it to contact form notification. From email, reply to. Now email recipient. This is where you can enter the email address of the recipient. This is the subject of the form, and this is the summary. Okay, let's save it. Okay, you need to enter the name, the field name, and I just created this one. So let me delete this one. Okay, now let's save. Now let's go back to forms. And this is the form that we have created. Click on it, get shortcode, copy it. Now here we already have shortcode. You can simply delete that one and enter the new one, update it. Now let's refresh it. Now here you will see the contact form using Caldera form. Okay, date picker is also there. Okay, so this is how the Caldera form will look. Now let's move on to the next form, that is WP forms. So before that, let me disable these two contact forms. Okay, now let's add new one. That is WP forms. Install it. You can see that the WP form is used by 4 million plus, and contact form 7 is also used by 5 million plus. Alright, so the plugin is installed. Now here you will see in the left panel WP forms. Go to all forms, it will show the list of forms, the dummy form. You can click on edit, and let's see how does this look. Okay, so you'll see this, your name, email address, and message. These are the three fields used in the dummy form. Now here are the different field options. You can select any one of them and use them. Now when you, now you see these are the grayed out. These are the fields that only pro members can use. So you need to purchase the pro license for that. So we are not going into the pro license. These are the field options. If you click select this one, these are the options for this particular field. Okay, so basically these are the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 fields that you can use for free. So there is definitely some limitations to use the free fields as compared to Caldera form. So that's why I like to use Caldera form. It has many fields that you can use. Now these are the email settings, contact form, the name of the form, form description if you want, the send button. Now here you will see confirmation. Okay, this is for 4. These are the general settings. Notification, send to email address, subject line, from name, email, reply to. Okay, so these are the fields, and these are the settings of the WP form. Let's save this one. Okay, now here go to shortcode, copy the code, and just delete this one and enter the new one. Click update. Now let's see how does this look. Okay, so this is how the form using the WP form will look like. So out of these three plugins, I really like to work on the Caldera form because it has many fields and it is more, you can say, customizable. You can make many changes to the form. You can create different sections on the form. So in the coming videos, I'll show you how to create the forms using all the three plugins, and I'll try to use all the fields on a single form so that you will get the idea of all the fields on these three plugins. Alright, so that's it for now. Thanks for watching.